team. So this story is called Greta and the Giants by Zoe Tucker. You might remember us talking a bit about a girl called Greta when we were at school. And you might remember that she also is really keen on saving the great outdoors, so it fits in very well with our topic at the moment. I would love you to follow along as I'm reading and see if you can jump in when I've missed out some words. You can either print out the transcript that is linked in the planning in the week 4, or if you haven't got a printer, you can look at it on a screen, or if you're watching this as a video and you can't fit both things on your screen at the same time, you can see if you can read along at the same time and jump in from the words that you can see on the page. There was once a girl who lived at the heart of a beautiful... Her name was... One morning, things weren't quite as they... Greta stepped out into her garden, and there, together in the shadows of the trees, were all the animals of her. A soft, silvery brown wolf stepped with his tail low to the ground. "Please help us, you. The forest is broken, and we don't know where to go. The giants are ruining our..." The giants had always been for as long as Greta could remember. But now they were huge, lumbering oaks, and they were busy. They chopped down trees to homes. They chopped down more trees and built homes. The houses grew into towns, and the towns grew into... They built factories and shops and cars and planes. They worked all day, all night, until eventually there was hardly any forest. But the greedy giants had forgotten how forest was. They didn't see all the little and bugs and butterflies and bears that trembled in the shadows. And no one told them to, because everyone was scared of them. Everyone except Greta. "Will you help us?" asked her. Greta looked around. The animals looked and sighed. She had to help them. But how? And Greta had an idea. The next morning, Greta went to the middle of the forest and waited for the giants to come. She stood alone, holding a big sign. The sign said, she waited. And waited. On the first day, the didn't see her, and lumbered on by, and on the second, and two. But on the fourth day, something strange happened. A little, who had been watching Greta, made her, and came and sat down next to her. He didn't say that, but Greta knew he felt. Soon, people and animals saw what they were doing and in too. Before long, a crowd filled the forest, stretching out to the city and the roads beyond. They stood and waited. The crowd was so huge that the giants were stopped in their tracks. "Please stop," Greta cried. "Your behavior is spoiling our home. You've broken the trees and trampled the flowers, and now the bees and birds have flown away. These animals are, and our forest is dying." After Greta had, everything was silent. But then everyone in there began to shout. "The smoke from your fires is choking the air. And please stop putting down the trees. You can help plant some new ones and mend my home." "We need to take care of forest and live together. Will you please try?" they all said. The giant shuffled and fidgeted, and their feet on the ground. They were embarrassed and a little bit. You see, the giants were so busy building, they didn't see what they were doing to the forest or the animals who lived there. The giants felt terrible. "We're," they said, and they promised to try harder. So from that on, the greedy giants weren't so greedy. They slowed down and learned to quietly. They stopped working all the time and instead took up new hobbies. They stopped chopping trees and learnt all about gardening and living in the. They cooked, repaired, tidied, and before long, the forest became than they could ever have imagined. Hopefully your team managed to follow along and jump in when I had missed a word. Now this story is full of slogans. That means short phrases, a few words pushed together, sometimes just one word. And these characters have them on posters and banners. Some right here. Right here. I would love it if you could try to write some of your own slogans. They're usually a few words that don't quite make a full sentence. Okay? And you could write slogans either about saving a special place in the great outdoors somewhere, maybe a rainforest, or maybe about not putting pollution into somewhere like plastic going into the ocean, which we already know a little bit about. Or maybe you could come up with your own idea that you would like to write some slogans for. You can either use plain paper or on purple mat or with a document called Greta and the Giant Slogans. See if you can have a go. I would love to read some of your own slogans that you have made up yourself. You'll probably need to leave lots of exclamation marks at the end of them. Well done.